Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's JaceyPenne. We're continuing the last bonus episode of Life is Strange Before the Storm. We already had to go up to the attic, stack a lot of weird, odd objects on top of each other so we can get in there so we can get this amulet. So we're going to have to go through this like a maze, I'm assuming, just to get this amulet. And old TV, old chair, crib. I honestly can't see anything here.
I remember it took this thing like 100 years to rewind the land before time.
All right. What about this crib?
Parents couldn't part with this. I guess I see where Chloe gets her sentimentality from.
Or her hoarding from.
I can't get through with this chair here.
So we're gonna move that because that was the only option. The only thing we could move.
Okay. I think I can squeeze through now.
Alright, so, squeeze through. Why is it saving? What's gonna happen? Am I gonna get crushed or something? Alright, we're getting closer. Alright, let's check this out.
It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kinda difficult.
Let's just look around a little more.
It's full of decorations Chloe made when she was 5. She thinks they're embarrassing, but I think they're cute. I need to move that desk, but distressor is in the way.
They really don't get rid of things. Because this looks like a baby, like a dresser Chloe had as a child. But I mean, it is the attic,
one
so.
One step closer.
They can put whatever they want up there, can they? Alright, so we're going to push this desk. Hello? Yes.
This desk is pretty heavy.
I would have just climbed over the desk, got what I needed, and got back out. Like, this is like Tetris, almost. Okay, so, what is this?
I never realized how much I liked vintage things. This cooler is awesome.
Whoa, why don't they sell this?
Glad this thing is empty.
Imagine if the parents are downstairs like, what the hell is that noise? Like, what is that? I guess we do it again. Yeah, just a little more. Get it out the way, all the way.
Yes.
Big space for us to go right in. Walk this way! Squeeze through. I think she's honestly making it a lot more difficult than what it is. I feel like she could just jump through all that and grabbed it. This is like an Indiana Jones type of thing right here. Like, finally she gets the amulet.
A fitting reward for a journey full of treasures.
That's cute though. That's a really cute little treasure hint.
Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works.
Imagine, like, oh, what is that? Who is she fighting with? Wonder what Rachel Amber was up to around this time.
My best friend.
Aww.
It's so weird being back in this attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about.
Agreed. I do.
And spiders.
And she's in the worst place where the spiders would be, the attic.
Ha ha! I have you now, Skellywag.
Man, I'm gonna miss her.
Ah,
you just watching me up there, Creeper?
You are one of a kind, Chloe Price.
What?
I'm lucky you're my best friend. That's all.
Damn right you are, you mushy weirdo. You find the amulet? Awesome. Now get your ass down here. We have treasure to find.
On my way.
Oh, I thought I had to go through that maze again. I was like, okay, what do I have to push now? Oh my gosh. But that was pretty cool. That was pretty fun. Just for kind of like reminding me of Indiana Jones. I think the very first one, Raiders of the Lost Ark, when he's like going in that place and like he gets whatever's in the middle of like that whole area and then he picks it up and then all chaos starts, like those big giant rocks come falling down. But yeah, it kind of reminded me of that, except minus the rocks and minus the chaos. And minus Indiana Jones, of course.
No big deal. Bring the amulet over here so I can see. Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plane.
If I can look around, I'll probably do this first, because I like
it's
looking
not
around.
That I don't like the blue. I'm just sad to see the old color go. One time, we stuck a bunch of this tape to Chloe's face to make a blue beard. Putting it on was a lot more fun than taking it off.
Okay, so they're painting the house. Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot her house is a different color in the game.
This was a fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow something. Poor Bongo.
Oh, there he goes.
Chloe took his death so hard.
Aww, the kitty.
I guess Chloe's mom comes all the way back here to smoke.
Jeez. That's insane. My god, she's like hiding that habit or just like, I don't know.
Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table. It's so weird we're at different schools now. I still wish I could live in the world we drew.
Do you guys still have a friend like this, like a childhood friend that you still talk to when you're older now? Let me know in the comments, because I kind of drifted away from my friends, from like that I was like so close to. Luckily, like, I do have a friend like my cousin who's like been a friend since childhood, so obviously we didn't drift away from each other, but you know, just actual friends in school, yeah, totally. So let me know in the comments how long you guys have been friends, if you still have any friends from childhood. That's interesting to know.
I'm really gonna miss Price family barbecues.
What's this? Soda bottle?
Chloe's bottle rocket. The fastest way to get an entire bottle of soda in your hair.
Alright, what's this?
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's rum for me. Did you drink this? Yar!
No, not really. I had to fish an empty bottle from the recycling bin.
That's probably for the best.
Some pirate you are.
It's interesting.
Glider swings. The best way to simulate a storm on the high seas.
Ah, my greatest work of art. I call it... Oh, I lost my magnifying glass privileges.
Great art is never appreciated.
Alright, anything else? What's this?
This thing looks so much smaller than I remember. I can't believe Chloe still has it. Actually, after this morning... Can.
Yep, she's like me. She saves everything, then doesn't know what to do with herself. Whoa, what was that about? That was weird, that camera circling everything. Throw this.
I've spent so much of my life here. Every little corner is familiar. Comforting.
Where am I going?
games we're playing. Buried pirate treasure from our past selves. Is this why I keep pushing off telling Chloe I'm leaving? Because I don't want to ruin this time together.
Yeah, because I think it would ruin it. That's just me. I wouldn't be able to think of about anything but that. Oh.
Bro. Don't you mean sis?
Maybe I meant nerd.
Dork.
Doofus.
Only doofuses say doofus. You know what, Max Caulfield?
What? Chloe Price.
You're the frickin' best. That's all.
Talk about mushy. Where'd that come from?
It's just thinking about how awesome this day is. And how awesome we are.
Oh god. Don't give me that option to tell her, because I feel like that... Okay, good. Because I would have.
Treasure to be unburying.
It was the most perfect time, but that wasn't an option, so we're just going to pretend that, you know, that wasn't an option. We don't have to pretend, it really wasn't. Yeah, cool. I was looking for that photo.
Chloe, yar. Land ho!
Perfect.
Okay.
I wish I could freeze this moment and never have to leave it.
Look up that flag really quick.
I miss Chloe more than the rest of Arcadia Bay combined. I never understood why it's called a Jolly Roger. How jolly can you be if you're dead?
Alright, now we talk to her.
Wait just a minute. Yar! You must ask permission before setting foot, or peg, on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Grrrr!
One amulet. Coming right up.
Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this stay on.
Stay here. I think I saw some tape.
Thanks, Max.
Just some tape left between us and the treasure.
Oh yeah, I think I know. It's that blue tape over there. Okay. What's that?
Are you ever gonna get your kite down from the roof?
It was unhappy in captivity. I set it free.
You must be a hero to kites everywhere.
Okay, so I thought I got everything, but apparently we missed that. Did we look at this?
I wish this was big enough to jump in.
I think we did.
It's only September. It'll be totally dive-bombable in a few weeks.
Yeah. A few weeks.
We don't have a few weeks. So we see that tape. We're gonna grab it.
One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is.
Alright. Oops, we could have spoken to her for a little bit.
Have you brought me prize?
Ahoy, Bluebeard. I have brought the stickiest tape in all the seven seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag. Just like old times. Come on.
Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were going to be pirates forever. If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, Then we'll always be pirates. Hell yeah.
I feel so bad for Chloe. I'm getting like emo right now. She's like one of my favorite characters in the Life is Strange. Well, obviously everyone loves her.
Would you like to do the honors, Long Mac Silver?
Are you sure?
Of course.
But I really loved Chloe and Max's friendship the most.
Point me to some treasure.
It was special. Yeah, Rachel and hers and Chloe's was as well, but it's just something different about Max and Chloe that I enjoyed.
How am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with something?
Here goes nothing.
And it also seems like Rachel and Chloe agreed. Hold on one second. Okay, so I'm supposed to line up this drawing, but it feels like also Chloe and Rachel, not agreed, but kind of related and came together off of, like, bad crap, like, just about, just very situational, like, things that have happened to them already. So L1's a spin. So I guess that's the sky? Yeah, they met under bad circumstances and kind of bonded over the crap that they were going through at that moment, so.
The drawing should turn the real world into something priority.
Okay, so it's this way. It's a ship. See? A boat. So now we gotta match it with... Alright. Let's try to make that perfect. Okay, so the treasure would be where that X is. Ah, let me see. Is this it? Am I wrong?
I think I have the right angle, but... Where...
Ah, okay.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
To your left.
Okay, take a step left. No,
wrong way. Yeah.
You said left.
You're left, kid.
Your other left. Go the other way.
The other way to my other left?
You know.
That way! Perfect! Now come towards me!
Right there!
Bingo!
My god, they put that very close to the cat that they buried. Bingo or bongo? Which is which? What's under there? I hope just the treasure and nothing else. This is kind of crazy because in Life is Strange, the very first one, they were doing the same thing, but that's where they found Rachel, which is kind of weird.
That is not what we buried.
What was that about? But yeah, it's kind of weird because they were both digging at that junkyard where they found Rachel, and it's like, I don't know, kind of weird. Digging there, digging later on, but for like... to find some really crazy heavy crap though. So, but yeah, this is pretty cute so far. It's sad though. I think I'm gonna probably get emotional. I hope this wasn't a goodbye to Max and Chloe. I hope they come out somewhere in the next Life is Strange series or something. Just for a second, just like a spell, like a 30 second like cameo at least. 10, just walk by. I just want to see.
Who's that?
Oh, get the tape player.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Okay, so that's pretty cute.
Ahoy there, Plankwalkers!
it's from her dad.
What the
heck?
By now you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I'll give you extra protection from the winds and rain.
That's cool.
I'm excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed. And always remember, The real treasure is...
friendship. Love.
Your
food.
Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground.
Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive!
Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you're so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
Yeah, I can't see that. So, Dear Chloe, how are you today? I'm doing very well. It's Friday, June 27, 2003. It's summer vacation. We're making a time capsule for you and me in the future. We're making it pirate themed. Wasn't it hilarious to find? These are some things we like. Favorite animal, Arabian horse, Max. Otter, Chloe. Favorite food, lobster roll, Max. Coffee, ice cream, Chloe. Favorite class in school, art of or library, and science for Chloe. Best friend, each other, both. How about you? Are you age 12 or more? What are your favorite foods, movies? That's all for now. I hope you're having a lot of fun and being a teenager with your best friend. Sincerely, Max. That's pretty cute.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe.
Dear Maxine, hello from 2003. Here's a record of how we spend our days. Can you guess which one is real? 1. We go to the same school and always sit together at lunch. Duh. 2. We have sleepovers at least once a week. 3. We like extremely salty pretzels. 4. We're in a race to see who can convince your parents to get a pet first. 5. We're going to live together when we can afford it and use only gold paint. 6. We have battled many foes and never fail to save each other. What did you guess? If you guessed all of them, you are right. Your friend forever, Chloe Price. Chloe Elizabeth Price. Excuse me. That's cute.
You were really funny. Mine was so serious.
Oh, yeah, that's you.
Seriously. It's true, so serious.
This
why
is
so,
so
serious?
Cool.
There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Dunno. I thought they'd be home by now.
Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff.
I'm gonna draw something.
Scratch art? I don't even know what that is. Okay,
all these
so.
Memories.
Oh, wow.
I want to look at everything. It's good to see you, old friend. It actually might be really fun writing once a week too often. Will I run out of things to say?
Well, if you remember the beginning,
such a good idea.
If you remember the beginning, life is strange before the storm. Max didn't even write to her. She lost touch easily, fast.
These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do.
The chopper. So it's a bike that flies, spins blades, switches pedals from wheels to blades, world's most comfortable seat. Flaming fingers, flint, steel, ray of sunshine, sunlight enters here, mirrors and lenses to strengthen sunlight, laser beams shoot out here. Wow, okay, very creative and different. I want to get those predictions, but okay.
Most of these are pretty far off base.
All right.
Hard to predict the future. Maybe it's better to enjoy the present instead.
Predictions for the Future by Chloe and Maxine. We'll still hang out with each other more than with any other person. Both of us are medium popular. Both of us are dating our second boyfriend, so already those two are not accurate. We do not make decisions without consulting each other, the talking skull of our enemies. Both of us have a pet. Chloe has visited Antarctica. Max could rave come. I guess could have come if she wanted. Could rave come. One of us has a little sister or brother. We're doing well in school. Yeah, so far off. Except, you know, Chloe's doing all right.
Holy crap.
It's the other part
it's
of the comic.
That comic in Chloe's room. Oh, this is gross.
Maybe you should come down and power of flight this dude's face off with me. Oh, wow. Okay. That was it.
Keep messing up my picture.
There are no mistakes in art. This container looks like it could last 100 years.
Let's see. Look at that magazine.
Lupin. We used to read every issue from cover to cover.
Okay.
I still haven't told Chloe about my news. Recording things was so much fun in third grade.
What's that? That's a picture of her and her dad there, I think, yeah. Alright, so let's look around this house again now that...
We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house. Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out-nerds me.
I'm surprised that she didn't clean up.
I love
this.
How Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic.
That's cute. Oh,
this
tidy up.
This is probably the last thing Chloe's mom wants to see after her shift at the diner.
Yeah, why not? You're leaving. The least you could do is wash the dishes. Chloe didn't even help. I thought she would be there, but I guess not. She's just like, I'll just keep drawing. Yeah, suck up, Max. Alright. So now that... it looks nice, though, thankfully.
I always look especially short next to Chloe. That was a good week. I used every possible excuse to be here for breakfast.
Good luck, hubby. We're so proud of your promotion. You get a week of two Wales waffles in your own house. Your loving wifey. Oh, yeah, she loves those Belgian waffles. When I actually played the very first Life is Strange, I made her choose waffles. I think she could have chose that or something else, but I can't for the life of me remember what exactly she could have chose. The opposite of the Belgian waffles. Maybe bacon and eggs or something like that? I don't know.
Now you've got something pretty to look at. Hey, little guy. Aren't you cold in there?
I do remember in the game, too, there was a deer that I kept following. I always wanted to know what that signified. I had my suspicions, but I mean, I don't really know.
You sure were troublesome to find. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this.
I know it represented one of the characters, but yeah, that was very interesting seeing the blue butterfly. I'm pretty sure was Chloe. A lot of people said that it was Rachel also, but I'm pretty sure it could have been Chloe, blue hair. Maybe the deer signified Rachel, or maybe it signified Max herself.
I wonder if that's the voicemail Chloe's mom was talking about. She did say she didn't want Chloe to hear it, but if Chloe's in trouble at Blackwell, this might be my only chance to get her to talk about it.
We're gonna play this. Play it. I wanna hear it.
Hold on.
Are you serious? I don't want my parents to hear that. I've never gotten in trouble like this before.
They already know. I saw an email on your parents' computer.
Yikes, nosy ass.
Shit.
What happened?
Something so minor. Her mom is exaggerating. I bet Marissa told her that I... I'm telling you, it's stupid.
Come on. You've gotta tell me what happened. I'm your best friend.
Man, none of this would have happened if I had you around. I wouldn't care what anyone said.
Sorry. I don't mean it's your fault.
Anyway, she wouldn't leave me alone, so I turned up her Bunsen burner in science. Just a little.
What?
No one got hurt, not even close. You know that I know what I'm doing.
Chloe, what do you mean she wouldn't leave you alone?
She was making fun of my clothes and calling me a scholarship kid.
Is
that why you wanted to throw away your hoodie?
Don't worry. I'll keep it.
Hey, you can handle this. You're so much cooler than she is.
Just to you.
Thanks, Max.
Well, now we know. See what this is.
Chloe's grandparents live in Idaho now. I guess compared to that, Seattle's not so far. These used to make great pirate swords. Goodbye, Vase. Soon you won't have to worry about me knocking you over anymore.
Okay.
I bet there's some really cute photos in there.
We'll get to that, because I feel like
looks
that's
like
gonna...
Chloe's a lot more responsible than I am with my allowance.
Oh, wow. Nice.
Hey, what if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO?
There's that wine stain.
Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it. Chloe looks so content when she's drawing. Is that what I look like when I'm taking pictures?
We'll take a photo in a minute.
This used to be the rainy day pirate ship.
There. Let's see.
I wonder if I could recreate this photo with Chloe now.
Oh, that's Chloe. That's so cute. So wait, I'd take a picture now?
Chloe and I have been friends for so long.
That's adorable.
Maybe I'm worrying too much about this move changing things.
I don't know.
I can see what you're doing.
Just don't move. The artist at work.
I thought I was supposed to mimic the other photo. How was I supposed to do that? Let's see. Maybe I'm supposed to, Oh, okay.
Yes?
Pose for a photo with that?
Okay. Tip your head back and put your arms out. And a really big smile.
Like this?
It's perfect. Stop moving. Really cute, Chloe.
You're not so bad yourself.
Oh, I'm a little bit hungry. How about you?
I'm okay. You're such a space hog. Move over.
Nope. Nope.
I think it's time to tell her. It's like a little bit of quiet downtime. It's sad. Oh boy.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Oh, I remember those.
How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now
I'm finished. Check it out.
Chloe always makes me look so much cooler than I really am.
That's cute.
The artist at work.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once our parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
It's a perfect time. Dinner, right? Oh no.
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She's already got enough drama from Blackwell.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right?
Got to. You just have to. I mean, it's the most perfect time.
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
My family's moving to Seattle. Really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Oh, wow.
We talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but bad at hiding anything.
So, she knew. Wow. Okay.
Don't worry, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
Why did you pretend like you didn't know?
I don't know. I guess I didn't want it to be true.
Aww.
We were both doing it. Weren't we? All that pirate stuff, doing the treasure hunt. Wasn't that fun?
Of course, but...
Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so... I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together, having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine.
Man, that's so sad.
Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
Oh, wait, what? Already? This is when he dies? No way.
Mom?
Black flies on the windowsill. We are the moon. Winter's stone, summer's thrill.
Oh my God.
Cracked and cold. See the sky is no man's land. A dark and plumed estate. Hope your needs a humble hand. Not a fox found in your play.
Wow, I'm actually speechless. Wow. Why would that? Oh my gosh, that's
can't
terrible.
You see, oh, or maybe you were the ocean when I was just a stone. Black flies on the windowsill. We are the home.
Looks like she's wearing the same outfit from Chloe's funeral. Like Chloe's like blank.
A gypsy's rhymes to face, but the road is weary with that fool found in your place. No man is an island, or this I know. But can't you see, or maybe you were the ocean when I was just a stone.
Wow.
I'm thinking if I could just see you, but we'll get good at it, great at it, we'll write and talk all the time, and then you'll come visit, and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen, even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you. Goodbye.
Thank you. Yep, I'm crying. Damn. You know, and these characters aren't even real, so it's just like... That's so sad. I feel so bad for Chloe and the crap that she went through from that point on, you know? And Max was, excuse my language, a shitty person. She did such a crappy job keeping in touch with her. I feel like she could have done a lot more, you know, in the beginning of Life is Strange Before the Storm. You see entries of Chloe angrily talking about how Max did not write back and she lost touch, or you even noticed, like, in the, in her phone messages that Max just wasn't getting back to her, texting or calling, and it kind of just ended up in them parting ways for a little bit and losing touch. And that's, you know, how she met Rachel. Like I said, Rachel came at a perfect time because they were both going through crazy crap, and well, I mean, they bonded and they had a great friendship. And when Rachel disappeared, Max came to Chloe, into Chloe's life at a perfect time again, and, you know, took care of her and made sure everything was okay. So I don't know, it was just really sad. It hit the heartstrings, you guys. It hit me a little bit, only because I knew how much, you can kind of feel in this game how much Chloe loves Max and how much Max loves Chloe, and especially at this ending, it was just kind of sad to see that happen that way. I really was kind of like, I had no idea that when the whole thing happened with Max and Chloe, like with William's death, it was right then and there. Whoops, my microphone messed up. But, you know, I didn't think it was right then and there that her father was gonna die. But then again, I saw that picture, I don't know if you guys remember, in the kitchen, and that was the picture that day. So, I mean, that's crazy. If you don't know what picture I'm talking about, the picture of Chloe and Max when they took the picture, and in the first Life is Strange, I went back to it to try to save William from dying. That was actually that same exact photo. So it kind of made me think, wait a minute, is this about to happen now? But it didn't cross my mind that it was literally like right there, like right that second afterwards. I didn't think that. I thought maybe they were trying to imply soon it would happen, not that same episode. So but yeah, guys, that's it. That's the end of Chloe and Max. I hate to say that. I really wish in some way, if the time frame was different in the next Life is Strange series, that maybe we see a little bit of Chloe, or maybe a future Max, whatever works. I would love to see that. Like I said, I really love the voice actor. I do not know her name, forgive me, that did the Before the Storm Chloe Fryce. She was great, but I do have a soft spot for Ashley Burt. She's awesome. I just really love her, so I'm glad that she was absolutely in this episode the entire way. I think she even had something to do with writing it as well. But yeah, thank you so much, you guys, for watching and seeing this last bit of Life is Strange with Max and Chloe. Yeah, till they meet again, right? Looking forward to playing the other Life is Strange series, so maybe, like I said, we'll see them. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, you guys, and please like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what you liked best about this episode, what made you sad, what didn't, what kind of made you angry, what you feel about Chloe versus Max, or the other way around, whatever. I would just like to know and hear from you guys. Thank you so much for watching again. I'm JaceyPenne, and I'll see you in the next one. And as always, please be kind to everyone. You never know what they're going through. Have a good one, you guys.